All right, folks, good afternoon to you. Welcome to the Grand West Ice Rink here in Cape Town, South Africa. I've got to make that point every time because we have people listening to us all around the world. It's 2 o'clock in the afternoon, local time here in Cape Town. Not too sure exactly what the time is, wherever it is that you're listening to us from. I know that we've got quite a lot of people listening to us from New Zealand, and so welcome to all of them. But wherever you are, maybe just let us know. Let us know what part of the world you find yourself in, and also maybe why you're tuned into this particular broadcast. I mean, obviously, you're a big ice hockey fan, which is fair enough, but maybe you're supporting a particular team, a particular individual, or maybe you've been one of those teams who've been here just recently and you just want to sort of have a little bit of a trip down memory lane. Whatever it is, certainly you are welcome to today's broadcast. Jeremy Harris here alongside Nadine Sheffield as we get ourselves ready for game number three, but day two now, and of course our first game of the day as New Zealand get themselves ready to take on Hong Kong. Really impressive performances from both of these two teams yesterday, Nadine, and looking for more of the same today?
Definitely. And you know what, I think these teams are going to go head-to-head pretty nicely. They've both got very good skills, they've both got like speedy players, they've got strong players, and they're all very tall, actually. Quite surprisingly, Hong Kong as well. Looking forward to number 7 on the Hong Kong team.
Yao Yam. That guy
fast.
He's just grease lightning. I promise you, I've seen quite a few world championship tournaments over the last several years, and he is so impressive. And he's under 18. I mean, think about it. He's under 18. Imagine when he starts playing full-blown senior men's.
It's going to be amazing. It's fantastic to see that kind of skill coming up. And I mean, we have this goalie from New Zealand who's also like super, super fast in the net. He is awake and he's on fire most of the time. His glove saves are fantastic. He just steals the pucks out of the air. It's fantastic to watch. I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, absolutely. Me too as well. I mean, it was a really impressive first day out for both of these two teams, coming away with identical winning results, 4-2 for New Zealand in their first game over Thailand. And then Hong Kong breaking local hearts as they beat South Africa 4-2 last night in what was a quite physical but really entertaining match. A very noisy Grand West Ice Rink last night. Don't doubt that it's going to be any less noisy tonight. I promise you, when Thailand come out onto the ice against South Africa tonight, it is going to be full and it's going to be noisy, and it's just going to get noisier.
It definitely will, and I'm looking forward to it. So these guys are now lining up ready to face off against each other, and we have the officials for tonight. The referee is Abdullah Al-Zidane from Kuwait, and we have our lines persons Doyin Choi from Korea and Mornay Moses from South Africa.
Nadine Sheffield has a little bit of a soft spot for the officials. She, of course, highly respected international official herself, and of course also played for her country. So if there's one person who can sit here and talk the game, certainly she is that person. Lots of experience, and certainly knows the rules inside and out, and will make those 50-50 calls for us through the course of the game today, and of course tonight as well. Really looking forward to getting this one underway.
Just short. As soon as the teams have finished their walk rounds, they'll come up and have their face off. They're running a little late, it looks like. A couple of minutes, nothing too serious. But yeah, definitely looking forward to this matchup. Do you think we're going to see a quick face off to a goal like we have in the past?
I wouldn't be surprised.
And the question is who?
Exactly. Who will do that? I've got to tell you, a couple of players who stood out for me in the New Zealand lineup was the captain, Jacob Carey. He was very impressive. But then also, of course, it was Marcus McDonald who was really good as well yesterday. Sebastian Chamberlain with the long, flowing hair, Nadine Sheffield.
There was somebody here who had like a long piece of hair, and I don't know what, if it was hair or if it was equipment. That was freaky, but I don't see it again.
No, we don't see that. And then, of course, we've mentioned number 7, the captain for Hong Kong, Yao Yam, who was just a revelation to watch, breathtaking. You almost struggle to commentate because it is just difficult to describe what you're seeing. Really good player.
Yeah.
Of course, all the talk done. Now it's time for action.
The puck's about to drop. Go Team Stripes. And away they go, and Hong Kong have won the face-off. Good precision passing, even though it's fumbling, they still have stick on it, and they yam straight into it with a quick shot here. And it's a goal! It's a goal!
It's a goal in 15 seconds!
Yeah, yam! What a fantastic start for the Hong Kong team. Wow, we.
I don't want to ever have anybody accuse me of overhyping a player.
No, but that. Look at this. Through butter. Deeks here, Deeks there, and straight over. Very skilled.
Joel Gerrard for New Zealand in the New Zealand goal had no answer to that. Yam cutting through the New Zealand defense like they were not even there.
New Zealand, I think, have just had a bit of a wake-up call. And they're back down in the Hong Kong zone, so let's see if they're going to answer that quickly.
Yep.
Generally, within 2 minutes is generally a good answer. And a lot of the time, hockey games go that way. Like, one will score, the next one will score within the next 2 minutes. You know, it's an answer, it's a quick one. But you never know. Sure, what a start.
What a start. I mean, you were talking it. I guess that for me, the most likely person to score a quick goal was Yam. And he did just that. Great pass there. Looking for a quick response, as you say, Nadine Sheffield. Not to be on this occasion, but it's still New Zealand. In comes the shot.
And a shot. Oh, what a save. And we got the number one keeper in tonight for the Hong Kong team, and that's David Lam. He's net-minding for the Hong Kong team today. He's already started off with a great job.
That's an interesting decision, because I thought yesterday it was... just have a quick look. It was Coleman Yang who was... I thought he did quite a good job.
He did.
Obviously, just a bit of rotation from the coach.
Okay. Ooh, the line got him. Oh, there's a sniper in the house.
The ghost sniper took out Kwok for Hong Kong. Here comes New Zealand looking for that response. They will not have enjoyed the way they just coughed up a goal there in that first 15 seconds.
Whistles blow. Oh, that linesman was quick off his mark.
Yeah, that linesman was quite impressive. His speed is also quite good, but he must have been pretty good.
And he's from Korea, yeah. So they also have these beautiful skills from the Asian countries, and it's actually awesome to watch. Their skills are just phenomenal. The stick handling and everything. The precision passing, it's lovely to watch.
That number 8 for New Zealand is a monster of a man.
Hong Kong winning that face-off.
He must be at least 10 meters tall.
I think the biggest we saw was 1.9.
Well, that guy is surely 10 meters.
10 meters.
Okay, let's have a look now. Looking for a way back out of trouble. I mean, since they've scored, it's been all defense for Hong Kong.
But I think it's because Lam's still sitting, catching his breath there. Maybe.
Just going, guys, I've done what you wanted me to do. I scored the first goal.
Taking a breather.
Here we go. Lots of pressure, lots of physicality coming from New Zealand. The one thing in that South African game was that it did seem to, I'm going to say, bother them a little bit. Ooh, was the physicality for Hong Kong, but they were able to make a way through it. Here comes Hong Kong looking for a way through. Not so easy this time around. In comes the shot. You don't shoot, you don't score, you know, Nadine Sheffield. But now.
Matthew Langford asking what happens to the winner of this tournament. Do they go to the higher grade? You know what? With all the possibilities of Russia and Belarus coming in to the divisions, I'm not sure if it's happening in the under-18s seed, but I will definitely check that in the break, and I will let you know. I'll check with the results managers here from IIHF, and I'll get you that answer.
It's a massive scuffle down against the boards there behind the New Zealand goal. Ultimately, though, it seems like New Zealand have come away with it now.
Carry with it.
Danger, danger, danger,
and it's an
danger.
Offside.
And so unlucky. I mean, literally, I'm going to say that was inches.
It was very close, but it was still offside.
Yes, it's definitely still offside. Kerry, as I say, is the danger man. Make no mistake, for New Zealand, maybe not as fast as his opposite number, the skipper for Hong Kong. But wow, Kerry also really lovely to watch him skate and play.
Yeah. He's got some beautiful skills. Oh, big hit there. Sticks flying. Nothing serious. I think Harry again. It's got, oh, just misses number 19 getting in a big hit there, trying to get his control. Offside. Hong Kong managing to regroup.
Danger man.
Yam.
Yam is it now. There's just trouble coming. Oh, well cut out. Bad pass from Yam. Got to say, that's the first time I've seen him. He made a mistake in the whole tournament.
Because he passed. He's not supposed to.
He's not supposed to pass. He's supposed to score the goal.
Shame.
Anyway, still all of the pressure coming from New Zealand, even though they are 1-0 down.
I have to send a shout out to New Zealand. We have to. Jen Jones, Jamie Jones, and they're all watching their little brother here.
Here we go, Yam with the questions, and dealt with this time by Joel Gerrard.
Jamie Jones and is her little brother, Nash Hayward Jones. Yeah, yeah. He's also playing number 9, and he's the assistant captain here for the New Zealand team. They've sent us some more little treats.
Oh, I love it.
And a lovely letter, and it's so appreciative. You have no idea how much that means to us that, you know, we've basically come into your homes to bring you this hockey and let you watch your family play. So
you don't have to send me the letter, though. You can just send me the sweets. Lady Sheffield likes the letters. No, I'm kidding. Thanks
he
for the
loves,
letter.
He loves the lumps. Oh,
love these lumps. We have created a monster. Okay, here we go.
Hong Kong again. Wong with it.
All business.
Wong got the MVP yesterday, didn't he? No, it was Lam. It was,
oh, it was definitely Yam who got it.
Yam, yeah. Somebody 11... I don't remember what team that was. It was yesterday's problem. Right, Hong Kong looking for the pass, trying to get around the New Zealand player. They're putting the pressure on.
There we go. There's your friend Chamberlain. Nadine Sheffield does have favourites. I'm just telling you now.
I don't have favourites.
She's got favourites.
I'm not like you. You always like the favourites. There's one favourite. He's not in this tournament.
Oh.
Hong Kong on the back check there. Picked it up. Dumping it out to Carey. Carey with an opportunity. Looking for the pass. Manages to get around. Oh. But not quite getting shot on target.
It's amazing. How, you know, when you're dealing with a good player, they're able to stand right next to you and still make space for themselves.
Yeah, they just do. They make the time for themselves. They make the space.
It really is so nice to watch. And I mean, I'm talking about almost any sport. Doesn't matter what it is, they can stand right next to you. Oh,
what
goodness.
An it! That's a brilliant deflection, and we've got
good
Koo.
Body position.
Koo going down,
and shot
big
comes
shot.
In.
Great save there.
Joel Gerrard's not going to call it out twice.
Great job. Ooh,
comes Carey. Great stick work. And in comes the back pass, and just over.
Wide open net, and just went high.
Shots coming in thick and fast. It's like
great effort here by New Zealand, trying to get another one or get one in so they can equalize. Great save there by the Hong Kong netminder. That's
okay.
David Lam. New Zealand 13 minutes 46 seconds in the period. Both shots 3-2-3 and one goal in for Hong Kong.
So it seems to be a consensus that the winner of this tournament goes to a higher grade. We are going to just double check that and come back to you. And Suchat says, "Hi, I'm from Thailand. Good day and welcome to you." Thailand, of course, in action a little bit later this evening, 7 o'clock SA time, local time here. In comes the shot. Skids past the left-hand upright. Looking for a way through. I've got to tell you, it's been mostly all New Zealand, despite the fact that it's Hong Kong with the 1-0 lead at the moment.
Nice and cool. Just over 13 minutes left. Let's see if I can get some on.
Now, the other player that struck me yesterday was Preston Luang from Hong Kong. A monster of a man. Massive physical presence. He's obviously not on the ice at the moment, but certainly he did cause problems just by the sheer size of him. Wow, that was pretty close. looking for a way through. New Zealand want that response. They want to get onto level pegging as quickly as possible. And of course, they're going to try to put pressure on the new keeper for Hong Kong. It's David Lam. He's in the goals for the game today.
Here we go. Howard Jones.
Oh.
Heywood Jones, sorry. Not Howard.
Howard Jones is a singer from the 80s.
That's why it's in my head. Heywood Jones. Sorry. I just want to see some fans like Stu. You remember Stu? That was funny.
What did Stu do?
Remember Stu had his face painted and
yes.
I had to do the whole face
you
painting.
You met him in the boys' bathroom?
Meet him in the
what
bathroom.
What were you doing in the boys' bathroom?
I walked past it.
In the boys' bathroom?
No.
No.
He was waiting outside.
He's got a girlfriend. You know that, right?
Exactly. So I was trying to help support him. Ow. The line. The sniper got that guy again.
Yeah. All on his own. Yeah. Here comes New Zealand.
Here we go.
Up the ice.
Patterson.
Looking for a way through. Great
also
stick work.
Great
shot to come. Try to lay it off. Maybe he should have gone for the shot. Backed himself. But not to be. Good defense there from Hong Kong.
New Zealand are definitely putting on all the attacking pressure.
Oh, yes.
Got possession, but Hong Kong are not letting up either. They've got great passing, straight through the middle, great big shots.
See, what Hong Kong are doing is they got that quick lead. I mean, that certainly wouldn't have been something that they would have necessarily counted on. It obviously plays to their game plan from here. But they are so precise. So they'll soak up the pressure and then find each other, because they know they will find each other when they break out.
Exactly. Their positional play is outstanding and they know exactly where each other are. Here we go. A chance for New Zealand. They've got a breakout.
Just the goalie to beat. Here. Great.
Save.
Great work. And that is against Jacob Carey. Of course, I would have backed him to score that one. Good work there from the new keeper. Hugs for the new keeper.
Beautiful breakaway there that he got. But, he just couldn't finish it. The goalie just said, nope. Just got it under his arm there.
Yeah, no, he was not going to let that through, let me tell you now.
Brilliant save. Face-off, the Hong Kong people are winning these face-offs every time. They win them back and they've get. Yeah. Okay, I'm giving up.
She's been drinking excessively, folks.
Excessive
I can't
coffee.
Lie. It's just so much. I'm the sensible one in the team, as you can tell.
So Jeremy does this for a living. He talks to people, broadcasts to people.
Here we go. And Koptev against the body there.
I can't illocute myself.
You can illocute yourself just fine. Just put that bottle down and do some work.
Everybody's going to think I'm an alcoholic and I barely even drink.
Yeah, I know, barely.
New Zealand are doing a great job down there. They are passing their puck around, keeping control of it. Hong Kong are battling to actually get possession right now. New Zealand with some shots.
Bodies
great
in the
defensive
way there.
Work.
Oh, that hurt. Kwok, the number 17 for Hong Kong, is going ouch.
There's a penalty coming, and it's coming to...
Oh,
I don't know, because it should have been blown a while ago. Let's see here.
I don't know who's getting the advantage. Even everybody's a bit...
That's
pushing.
A cross-checking, from what I can tell. I think it's going to be on New Zealand. Okay, checking from behind. It's supposed to be hands up.
Yeah, but this guy's a bit excited.
Okay, so he called it checking from behind. But he's showing a cross-checking hands. And it's Hong Kong.
I mean, the referee's very upset.
Okay, so we have number 18 coming in here from Hong Kong.
This guy,
from behind.
He doesn't look like he could have done anything wrong.
Leighton Lam.
No. Not Leighton.
Yeah. Right, so he's getting 2 minutes for checking from behind.
Wow. Did you even see that?
No, I was busy looking at my computer.
That was just a bullet picked out of the sky like it was a fluttering butterfly. Let me tell you now. David Lam. Hopefully we can get to see that again. That was something to behold. Really great keeping there. Still the pressure coming from New Zealand. Dealt with though. by Hong Kong, who are one player short. It's a power play. It's exactly what the doctor would have ordered for New Zealand. In comes the pass. And now, surely, opportunities.
Goal crease infraction. I'll have to watch the replay. So on the stat sheet, on our live stats at the moment, it is calling, they have called it cross-checking.
Yeah.
I didn't get to see the actual hit on the replay, so if I do get to see that, I can see whether the referee was meaning to say cross-checking or if it was meant to be from behind. But he definitely showed the signal for cross-checking, but he sounded out saying from behind. So, sorry for the confusion. New Zealand winning that face-off. Good passing up to Carey. Carey looking for the opportunity. Who's getting free? Down to number 13 in the corner. Back up to Carey. Carey looking for another pass across. One timer down on the ice. Beautiful, but doesn't quite get through. Great clearance there from the Hong Kong team. Just under 9 minutes left in this period. Okay, so by the way, you were asking me about the trapezoid. And I sent you
people like it, eh? They definitely don't like it.
I saw the link about the people protesting to free the goalies of the trapezoid. So the trapezoid is a rule that's come out recently, a few past few years. Goalie is only allowed to play the puck behind the red line within that trapezoid area.
Behind the red line.
Yes.
They would definitely play it in front of the red line.
In front of the red line, he's allowed to play pretty much within this whole zone.
Okay.
But he's
hold
not
on a second, and shot comes in.
Deflected wide. Another opportunity. Oh, just didn't get his hands on
New
it.
New Zealand are just one attack after the next.
They're firing it away, but Hong Kong doing a great job of clearing it. So the goalies can play the puck only behind in that trapezoid. Only within there. They can't go to the other two corners like they used to be able to.
Right.
But in front of the line, they're allowed to go and play the puck. So I hope that clears your question.
Power play is a thing of the past. It's 5 versus 5 at the moment. And Hong Kong have done well to weather that storm. There were so many attacks.
Oh, no one do have that assist there.
Dealt with there. Gerard in the New Zealand goal. He will not be happy with the fact that he let that early goal in. Pressure coming from New Zealand. Still mounting attack after attack.
I just want to quickly send a quick shout out while we've got some chance here. Patrick Sanford saying Matthew Langford, yes, the winner goes to the higher grade, meaning the higher division. There is definitely no relegation because this is the lowest division in this under-18s men's, juniors as we call it. Peanut and Jason saying let's go Marcus, and Alice and Janice Juice saying go New Zealand go, and Ashley Marsh, our former national team coach and coach here in South Africa, who now lives in Australia. Hi, Nadine. Great job to be able to watch the Under-18 World Championships. I'm loving the commentary as well. Nice hearing South Africa accents. Miss it so much. Nice to see and hear you too, Ashley. Miss you. Ding. Private joke.
Steady on now. See you get out of hand sometimes.
New Zealand are doing another great job of controlling the puck down there in the Hong Kong defensive zone. Hong Kong managing to come away with it. Now they're setting it up, looking for the long pass. Tried to intercept, but didn't quite get there. But Hong Kong still coming away. They've also got
good
stick handling.
So quick, so good. Looking for a way. And they don't give it up. They don't just blindly throw the puck somewhere. They wait until they can get one of their players to it.
Felix Hinder saying, let's go, Sam. We've got somebody saying hello from UAE. Michael Lamb saying go Hong Kong. Michael Lamb obviously must be relative of one of the players.
Oh, right, of the goalkeeper, David Lamb. I wonder, are you?
Yeah, and even Oscar Lamb.
Could very well be.
Are
lots
brothers
of families watch each other long distance during this World Championship event.
Patrick Sandiford is saying hello from the Netherlands. I was watching the live stream because I'm a big ice hockey fan.
There we go. Patrick answering my question from earlier, going, where are you watching it and why? I mean, he's answered both of those questions. Thanks very much, Patrick. Good to have you along.
New Zealand managing to come out of their zone. number 13 with some pressure, three of them trying to get to him, and
traffic.
He still gets through, but not quite getting on target with a shot. New Zealand dumping it back down to number 13. Great move behind, a quick shot up, and a
point. Goal!
Number 11 from 13. What a beautiful work there. He worked it out, passed it back through the slot, and they got their stick on it and just hammered it through.
Got to tell you, that's the least that New Zealand deserve.
What an equalizer.
They have been pushing, literally since the start of the game.
Now Marcus MacDonald gets that goal, I think. Let's see here. Beautiful shot.
Really top effort.
Marcus MacDonald from number 13. Ivan Dalmatau, I think that's how you say it. Well
done.
Speaking
of correction, I think Marcus MacDonald was our MVP yesterday in the game against Thailand. We'll double check that. Name sounds similar to me.
I don't know. I have to look.
Yeah.
So Marcus MacDonald, he definitely got the goal, and Ivan Dalmatau.
Dalmatau, yeah.
So, 5 minutes left in the period. Shots 6-6. Score 1-1. Very even. Although majority of the play has been down in the Hong Kong defensive zone.
Exactly. I mean, the fact that it's only 1-1 means that Hong Kong have done a really good defensive job, because I can promise you, on the balance of play, New Zealand have just been launching assault after assault on that Hong Kong goal. No way through up to this point.
Yesterday's.
Marcus MacDonald was the MVP.
Yeah.
There we go. But his name sounded familiar. He's trying hard to pick up another MVP award.
And Yu Yam yesterday for the Hong Kong team.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. Shot comes in. Long range effort and snaffled.
Snaffled.
That's
a Jeremy word.
That's a Jeremy word. I make up these words at every tournament, guys. Stay tuned.
We've got Anthony Lam saying, go Hong Kong from Japan.
There we go.
Matt saying, hope the Kiwi boys get a good job done. Where is my boy Usain, aka Yam Yam, from Ice Freak?
Where is he? It's a good question. We haven't seen him since he scored. Oh, no, he's on. He's on the ice at the moment. He is like Usain Bolt, is the number 7 for Hong Kong. Yam Yam, do not give him the puck because he is gone.
Ooh, nice hit.
Flattened. Why don't you take a seat, sir?
That's the hockey amus.
And another one. Just a little bit of payback. There we go. That's number 8 I was telling you about. Preston Luang.
And here we go. Yam. Oh, it just doesn't get past. Great job there by his equal number 7 there. Stopping him from getting through.
The Hong Kong number 8 is a big unit, so he is difficult to get past, and certainly when he takes an interest in offering you a seat on the ice, that is going to come. That is going to happen.
There's a lot of high sticks in the face there. I would have given Lewis a bit of a penalty for that one.
Nadine Sheffield is a very strict official. Here we go. Shot comes in. It was just sort of muffled by the defense from New Zealand. Now, here it comes, 23 for Hong Kong, deflected off the skates.
Carey Stertia, yeah, he got in the way of that. That's a great job. Putting your body on the line. New Zealand just getting past their sticks there.
Pass New Zealand up. Will want to go into this break ahead.
They do. They want to get a security goal.
Yeah. They
well,
will
it's
not
a security goal, but it's another goal.
They will not want to be 1-1 or whatever, at the end, certainly not trailing.
Well, look, at least they are back on the board, which, again, is a huge feat, which they've done. So that's already a plus. But as I said to you in the beginning, I said these two teams are going to be very evenly matched. And I think it's going to be a
great
game.
Great save there from Gerard. That one was going in.
It's going to be a situation of who wants it more. And Hong Kong have got the skills and the speed and the patience. Lee up there, taking it around, looking for somebody in the slot with an opportunity, but not quite getting
pass.
On there.
I mean, he was going backwards into the board, still able to get the pass. across the face of the goal, but nobody there to take advantage of it.
I see. I mean, offside.
It's very seldom she gets this confused. I think it could be the sweets that we were given from the people in New Zealand.
I think New Zealand's doing it on purpose.
In future, guys, don't send Nadine Sheffield any sweets. Send it to me. I will take care of it. Because ever since we got the sweets from the lovely
people
in New Zealand, I just want to say thank you so much for that. But I think in future the lesson's been learned now, folks. Don't send it to her. Send it to me. I will take care of it. Thank you.
Jeremy.
That will be the last we speak about that. Okay, here we go. New Zealand. Under pressure. Under pressure. Still under pressure.
We've got Tria R saying, go Hong Kong. And Corey Bolton. Corrine Bolton saying, nice goal, watching from Calgary.
There we go. People are answering the questions. I like it. There's Canada, there's Hong Kong, there's Thailand, there's the Netherlands. Shot comes in from the number 8. Pressure coming. He's aware of his physical presence. He knows he's a danger. Off the body of his own player. In comes the shot across the face of goal. Tell you what. How did we get to 1 minute and 13 seconds left? Now, New Zealand. They will not want to cough up an early or a late goal, I beg your pardon.
I have a sneaky suspicion Hong Kong's going to come back with another.
Oh, here we go. She's normally right, folks, which is always scary.
I love watching these Hong Kong guys. They get it so nicely, precisely in there. But, oh, what a lovely wipe out there by number 7. Beautiful hockey there. Doing exactly what's needed.
There we go, just flipping that one down there. Great skip. Oh, it's
that's sniper again.
It's a dangerous place, the ice at the moment. Shot comes in, long range effort, off the
great
pads.
Great save. I don't know how he saw that, honestly.
I'm telling you, this guy, Joel Gerrard, is the
he's
real...
He's lost his stick. His stick's standing there. But he's managed to get hold of that puck. 13 seconds left on the goal, on the clock.
Good effort there as well from number 21, Sam Wong for Hong Kong. Pushing, pushing. He might have had maybe two shots at in the same movement. Look at this. Here he comes. And again and again. And there's like three shots that he took in there. Not able to get it.
13 seconds.
Gerard's going for get, pal. I New may Zealand. Have coughed up an early goal. I'm not going to do it again.
New Zealand won that one. Big shot on the ice. Looked after there. Yo.
Wow.
Cutting down trees.
Wow. That is crazy.
1-1.
That is
the end
crazy.
Of the first period. What a great game of hockey. That was nice. Matt saying snack exchange sounds good. Would trade Kiwi Sweets for Biltong in depth.
Oh, that's a good trade, Matt. Listen, let me just quickly tell you as we go to the break after the first period of play, the score is 1-1. That, I mean, is the fact of the matter. But what the other bit of useful information is that let's have a look at that shot clock quickly, Nadine. What does it say?
Sorry.
It's all admin. All admin.
11-7.
11-7 at the moment. It's suggesting that Hong Kong have had the better of the first period. So I've got to tell you, it doesn't tell the story. It doesn't tell the story of. Probably a, I'm going to say a 10-minute period, maybe even more, 12-minute period of just relentless pressure, rather, there was no pleasure, just pressure from the New Zealanders, just piling on the attack after attack,
yeah.
Firing in shots, admittedly not on target, so that's why it doesn't add to our shot clock. But, I mean, the fact is that they were just pushing hard all the time, driving for the equalizer. They got it. And in fact, I felt that they would score again.
Yeah.
You felt differently, and we almost saw that come to pass at the end of that first period of play. But very exciting. You called it early goal to start with. That
it was
15,
really awesome.
15 seconds in from the danger man for this tournament, I think.
Yeah.
Number 7, yeah, I am. Looking forward to a second period of play.
Definitely am. Yeah, guys, please stay tuned. Keep sending your shout outs. We'll try and get to you as soon as we can. I just want to send shout out here to all our wonderful sponsors that have made this tournament possible. So thank you very much to all of you guys. City of Cape Town, Aquila, the Ice Station, Western Cape Government, DigiCape, Bloberg Meats, the Department of Sports, Arts and Culture, Signage Hub, CompuTicket, Eurosteel, Carol Boys, Heart FM, Sascock, Western Province Ice Hockey Association, Intro South African Ice Hockey Association Federation. Now I'm saying the wrong word again. Graphic Thought Design, IIHF, Grand West, Sun Grand West, Pedigree Media, and CFW Fans.
What is actually in your coffee cup? I mean, is it coffee?
You bought me this coffee.
Wow, guys.
So I don't know what you slipped in there, and it's worrying.
It's disturbing.
Anyway, we'll see you guys in a bit. Cheers for now.
And welcome back. It's almost time for the start of the second period of play between New Zealand and Hong Kong, tied at one apiece after a very exciting first period of play. I mean, literally, I feel as if there's something that Nadine Sheffield knows about this game, because she called it. She said it's going to be an early goal, 15 seconds in, and the Hong Kong number 7, Yao Yam, was able to, finesse his way. He just glided through the defense and scored after 15 seconds. That certainly rattled the New Zealanders, but they came back and just were mounting onslaught and attack after attack, and eventually equalized through Marcus McDonald. Really good, well-deserved score for New Zealand, because they certainly had been piling on the pressure. And it ended, I think, a little bit sort of in Hong Kong's favor. They were asking many questions of the Kiwi defense, and they were able to answer those questions. So that's why it goes 1-1 into the break. But, I mean, Nadine Sheffield, what a first session of play.
Yeah, no, it has been a very, very interesting game. Lovely to watch between the two teams. I think New Zealand may have underestimated Hong Kong a little bit. But you never know what's going to happen now. I think they're both going to come out fighting hard, because they obviously want to win. They're both equal right now. New Zealand are going to come out and probably fire all their shots in the ice like we saw, trying to get some tip-ins and some deflections. But we'll wait and see. Hong Kong have got some secret snipers, so I think they're going to put a few away maybe. But definitely going to be an interesting second period, that's for sure.
Yeah, exactly. I think, though, that New Zealand have learnt their lesson, and they're not going to let it slip as quickly as they did in that first period. They're certainly not going to want to leak an early goal. If anything, they want to put the shoe on the other foot and come away with a quick strike.
Here we go. New Zealand winning it back. Tran just intercepted there by Hong Kong. Number 8.
Was the danger man and just takes it away.
Oh,
just not able to control. I thought that was a shot and goal to come, but not to be, as New Zealand come away with it, looking for a way through. Heavy traffic to give it to Jacob Carey was a little bit putting him under a lot of pressure. Good stick work and good skating there, but not able to control it. Still, though, it's New Zealand with it.
Hayward Jones up to number 17 here. Hong Kong managing to keep it down. Number 7.
Offload comes in. Great
big
save.
Shot fired. Oh, off his own player's shin. Not quite getting to the net.
Oh, that's going to leave a mark.
New Zealand trying to get it out of their zone.
Yeah, playing with fire there, but
Hong Kong are now putting the pressure on. They want to get that
to
next
come.
Goal. And they're getting the shots.
Rebound still with Hong Kong. Still with Hong Kong. Looking for a way through as New Zealand weather the storm.
Hong Kong taking it back. New Zealand getting a full change. They've been defending quite some time now, so that change was crucial.
Dorothy Tam on our message line going, go Hong Kong. Shot comes
big
in.
Big shot, beautiful save there.
Absolutely grabbed under the air, I like it.
That's from David Lam, number 1 goalie there for the Hong Kong team. I'm actually looking forward. I'm hoping Hong Kong is actually going to play in red tomorrow, because I like their red jerseys. They're very striking.
Oh, you mean on Thursday? Rest day
I
tomorrow?
I mean Thursday, yes, sorry.
But yeah, I know what you mean. What a shot. Are you even kidding me?
Where did it go? Like, I know it went out of bounds, but off what?
Ladies and gentlemen,
the
despite safety issues and
reports
that the facility
remains. And it's won by New Zealand. big shot there. Shot trying to get in. Some deflections on there, but not quite getting stick to it. Icing on.
Surely not.
He took a bit of time. The front linesman took a bit of time, but you know, it was hard. They were racing tough.
Yeah, they were going after it. So I mean, surely not. In comes.
At that point, you just leave it.
Wow, good effort there from number 13, Iman Dalmato, looking for a strike. Pulls it out the back of the Hong Kong goal, and away come Hong Kong with it.
Very powerful passes that Hong Kong have.
Yeah.
Actually, come to think of it, they actually all have very powerful passes and powerful shots.
Shots, exactly.
Oh, that Dalmato looked a bit of it. Ah, I so would have seen that tripping. Tripping.
Yeah, I've got to say I'm with you on that one because that was quite a distance away from the boards.
Well, you see, it doesn't matter where it was on the boards, but the fact that his feet got taken out from behind.
Yeah.
It's almost a slew foot. But that's also like a match penalty kind of thing. Extremely dangerous, but I didn't quite see it. So maybe we'll see a replay. But unfortunately, the referee didn't see it. Maybe he didn't see what I thought I saw. I could be completely wrong.
I doubt it.
No, it's very possible because I caught it out the corner of my eye.
Here we go.
No. This is the shot.
That's a good shot. Good protection of the goalkeeper as well. And here we go.
First warning to Hong Kong for delay. Hong Kong battling in the back there. New Zealand coming away with it, looking to set it up. Dumping it back down low. They're working it around the corners. Good cycling here. Well, not necessarily cycling, but good play down the corners and the boards by the New Zealand. They're controlling it to get
here
the opportunities.
Good save there from Lam.
Icing on. Oh, he's trying.
Very definitely an icing call there. Here we go. Here's that one where.
Go back. Slowly back. Slowly back. Replay. I would have, but the ref can only call what he sees. Sometimes you do miss these things.
The puck dropped at his feet, not able to quickly adjust. So it's a reset for New Zealand. Great passing. Stick to stick. You always love that. Gosh, almost took out the goal.
An opportunity, yeah, but he couldn't quite get his stick on it. Chong.
Speed now from New Zealand. Goodness.
Yeah, check those feet. Almost running on the ice.
Wowzers.
I don't know how these guys do it. They just look like so, I don't know, just look so fast. And they just don't, they look so light on their feet sometimes. I mean, you always get the thumpers and then you get these guys that just look like they're floating in the air. Twinkle toes. Icing again from the Hong Kong team.
Have a look at this. Wow, that was once again, it's Kerry leading from the front. In comes the shot, just all hooked up in all of the sticks and all of the other body parts, and shot comes in, dealt with there by Gerard in the a New Zealand goal.
Big hit there into the net. Shot wide.
That's a bullet on the shot though.
Beautiful. New Zealand managing to keep it down there. looking for the outlet pass, but Hong Kong holding him up nicely. Good battle. New Zealand managing to get it out, but not necessarily the direction they wanted to. McDonald with it now. McDonald trying to get around. Big shot. Up and over. Hong Kong with it. Number seven.
Danger, danger, danger. And just not able to.
Beautiful defensive work there.
At the crucial moment, you can see Yam very unhappy with it. Lost control.
Boniface got hold of that one quickly. Cleaned it away. Lots of sticks. Hong Kong with a shot. Beautifully saved.
Good save there from Gerard. That's still anybody's puck. Pressure from New Zealand.
With it. 22, I mean, taking it around the back, looking for changes. Looking for somebody to pass up to.
Oh, must be.
Oh, and almost a deflection through, but goalie managing to keep it away.
What a good setup. What a good build-up there from New Zealand. Patient build-up. They waited. They found each other. They took the shot. And, I mean, to be fair, really good work there from David Lam in the Hong Kong goal.
It's gone a bit quiet in this side. I don't know if it's just me or is there something building up. I'm hoping something's building up. We've got 14 shots to 12. Just over 12 minutes left. Or almost just under 13 minutes in the second period. Big shot there from New Zealand. Oh.
Again,
they're coming firing now.
He had to be completely awake, not only partially. Here comes an opportunity. It's 12 for Hong Kong. Lee with the puck.
Oh, New Zealand managing to overturn it. That, come on, he's gonna definitely get a penalty. That's number 8. He's either gonna get a hooking or a hold,
surely.
Maybe a slash. No, he's getting a hooking call. So it's obvious, dude. Your stick was up above his hands, on his gloves. That's not... Yeah. You can't deny that.
Steady on now. You know you get excited.
That's Preston Leung, number 8. No, it's Koo,
definitely. Preston Leung's enormous.
Where did I miss Koo? Number 3.
Oh, wow. I mean, he even left the stick on the player.
Well, that just shows you the jersey tucked away. Yeah. No, it's... Good call, ref.
Hayward Jones coming away with it. Rebuild, reset, plenty of time. Good composure from the New Zealanders now. Looking for a way through. They've got a one-player advantage on the ice at the moment. Will they make it count?
They've got composure. They've set it up. They had a beautiful breakout. They're in there. They're passing around. Looking to pull the goalie, get the quick shot off. But intercepted there. Well done to the Hong Kong, but can't get it out.
Good stick with
New
shot
Zealand
comes in.
It. It's still loose.
Tell you what, Lam is all business in the goal there.
Oh, quick shot, not quite on target on his stick. They're still managing to keep it going. Let's see if they can get a quick one off here from the other side. Carry with it now.
He's in danger, man.
Down to number 13.
They're going to get it back to Carry. And now to Hayward Jones, surely.
Oh, Carry's going to carry it. No. Cycle, drop pass.
And
Hayward Jones
has got it now, looking for a way through. No rush. It's one thing I enjoy about this New Zealand team is that they will set themselves up until they know it's time to take the shot, but they will find each other. There's no low percentage shots here. They will find each other. They want to be guaranteed of it, stick to stick. It's lovely to watch. Looking for a way through.
Oh,
there's a scuffle in there. Just not able to get it.
Oh, he couldn't
get it off the ground.
Just couldn't get it up.
Off the ice.
Lifted. Oh, no. Open net almost.
Wow.
Just not getting it on the stick. Opportunities are coming. It's 15 seconds left in this penalty kill for Hong Kong.
No, Hong Kong have done well.
They have.
Weathered the storm. I mean, I tell you what, those last few seconds.
Great job.
Was just... Sticks flying, puck flying. It was really exciting, but they've weathered the storm. It's all equal now. 5 plays 5. with the score at one apiece, and just at about the halfway mark of the second period of play. Now, New Zealand looking for a way through. Lots of pressure coming from Hong Kong. Still the pressure, still the position. Will they show the same composure? Will New Zealand allow them to be composed?
Move the puck. They moved it. Who came out with it? New Zealand managed to get hold of it.
Look at that pass across the ice, stick to stick. Oh, nicely done there by Hong Kong, the number 13 for Hong Kong.
The defensive work is going great at the moment, actually.
Marcus Fung, who just was able to crucially just get involved.
Just not managing to keep stick on it. Big long pass. They're going to go for no icing.
I'm surprised by that.
I didn't see who won the race. But clearly New Zealand.
What a pass. Demanding it.
Carry to Jensen Milton. Oh, there's a stick. Somebody lost his stick.
Oh,
the whistle had blown already and they're still fluttering around there, so I don't know whether it went in. We'll see with the other angle, I'm sure, but it looks like it's under the goalie and not over that line.
There we go. That's how close it is. You can see the puck lying there just short of the red line.
Ah, this is the angle we like.
Not controlled. Ooh. Rolls between his legs.
Just
and rolls and rolls and rolls and...
Great save there by the defensive.
Great save.
Yeah, that's good work.
And the whistle had blown.
Very, very good work. That's teamwork.
That was going in. Everybody's having a whole conversation.
It was that wounded rabbit situation. They're rolling in.
So what are they talking about at the moment?
I don't know. I'm not there. I can't hear them. We should mic them up.
We should mic them up, yes.
That'd be dangerous.
Please don't hit the goalkeeper in future is what they're saying. Okay, here we go. It's the restart. And that is about as close to a goal as you're likely to get without it being a goal. Shot comes in. Still New Zealand. Pressure, pressure, pressure all the time.
Passing on. Hong Kong do these, but they generally win the races. But New Zealand are definitely putting in the effort not to let them.
Now, again, I'm surprised by that call because it's an icing call.
It's correct.
But, I mean...
It's correct because in order for it to not be icing, Hong Kong has to beat New Zealand to the face-off spot.
They've got to get it
spot.
First. Okay,
they
thank
have
you.
To... At that face-off spot is where you make the decision. Okay. And if they're head-to-head, generally, you're going to call it. If they're going to win, then it's an icing.
Okay. Here we go.
That's the hybrid icing. Right. Here we go. D to D. Barry to number 7.
Great
up
pass, just not able to control it, stick to stick. I'm loving it. Here we go. It's Hong Kong with the puck, looking for a way through.
Koo with it. Koo to Wee.
Not able to get it. You see the fans throw their hands in the air. How did we not score on that one? Jensen Middleton.
Offside. Carey went down. I didn't see that. I think he was trying to go back onside and then got taken out by one of the Hong Kong players. Just over 8 minutes left. Our shot counter is showing 17-14 at the moment. And still, people, it's 1-1. It is looking really even at the moment.
It's not going to stay this way, I can tell you that, Nadine Sheffield. There will be a winner in regulation time.
I don't know. Maybe we'll have an overtime period. It'll
That's
be nice.
It's exciting, eh? Yeah.
It's always exciting to have overtime. Then they have the sudden death. And if they can't win there, then they have those beautiful penalty shot situations, which is always exciting. But, of course, you never actually want to do that because you actually get less points winning in an overtime, obviously.
Okay.
Winner getting 3, draw
unforced,
you get 2.
Unforced error. New Zealand team have a special move called the Flying Kiwi. Watch out, Hong Kong. Flying Kiwi. It sounds like a drink you order from a bar.
I would like to know what that is.
Yeah. Everybody's having a sit down. Here we go.
George Dupre asking me how Kamish is doing. Well, he's been around. He's with the team. He is here, but he's obviously unable to play. His arm's in a sling. I'm not entirely sure what the situation is with him, if it's healing like so, or if he's going to have surgery or not. But I can try and find out some more info from you. from them. At a later stage, Hong Kong with it behind, dumping it around, not quite clearing it. 7 minutes left.
Ooh, chance. Great save there from Lam. I mean, that was almost like a reflex save.
I sing again. I'm just laughing at Tinsel fans saying, actually, Kiwis can't fly, which is the funny part. We know that.
That's why it's a secret move, guys. It is a secret special move.
Kiwis and ostriches. We have the bigger bird here. Flightless birds. Right, we have a very tall Linton facing up against a very smaller in stature Hong Kong player, number 18.
Listen, I want to remind you about Dillian Ruda, who isn't the tallest player in the world, but wow, a bundle of energy there. She, of course, played for the South African women's team at the recent World Championships just a few weeks ago, and she didn't care what the size was.
No, feisty little one, that one.
Very feisty. In fact, she's leading a petition to bring back body checks into women's hockey.
I love it. Oh, it's your own player. Take your own player out.
Yeah. Not too sure you can be upset about that.
Yeah. Oh, sticks flying. Bodies on the floor. Okay, another icing. Hong Kong are not allowed to change. Leong needs to get back on the ice.
Sorry, the door is closed. Ouch.
Linesman doing a great job tonight. Shout out to all the referees and linesmen here, the officials from IIHF. Without you guys, there is no hockey, so thank you. You know, you must go every day to an official and thank them.
I see an official every day. I sit next to her, I make a coffee. What more do you want from me?
Coffee that's spiked with a language barrier.
Shot comes in and it's a goal!
Number 7!
Sniper out of nowhere. Sebastian Chamberlain, your favorite.
What a beautiful goal. Snuck in straight from the point on the blue line. Lovely shot for the New Zealand team, putting them up 2-1. 6 minutes left. Now that is going to rattle Hong Kong, and they're going to come back fighting hard. They've been working really hard, and they really want to come back with this. Look at the shot.
Look at the long range.
Clearance, and he's not even screened.
It is a bullet.
To the far post. Well done.
Poor David Lam up to that point was just impeccable. But, you know, when they come at you like that, maybe it was even dipping through the air. Do you think that Max Simpson got a touch in it?
I don't know. I'd have to see a replay. I didn't see a touch on it, but they've given Max Simpson, number 21, the goal, and they've given Sebastian Chamberlain, number 7, the assist.
I really would like to see that one. I would like to see that one again.
Yeah, I didn't see a touch from any New Zealand player. I'm surprised at that, actually. I really think it was.
It might have been why it was that Lam couldn't cover it, because maybe at the last minute it was a touch in it.
Mm. Chamberlain with it now. Intercepted by number 7, Yam.
Danger. And great save there.
Trying to put an answer on that board.
Have a look at that goal scored. Here it comes. You'll see in the far left-hand corner, it's Chamberlain. He gets it, smashes it in, and
yes, it was a chip. He did. But it was number 14.
But it was number 14. It was Jacob Carey.
It was Jacob Carey.
I mean, Max Simpson was nowhere near that.
Yeah, I think we will have to have a chat too. Points people to watch that again. Anyway, let's get the right guys the right points. Here we go. Hong Kong with it behind their net. Oh, a sniper in the house. There's definitely one around here somewhere. I think we need to make a video. Find that sniper. Right, Hong Kong putting the attack on. Chip up into the zone. Can they get a shot off?
Looking for a shot. Looking
Mark
for the way to
shoot.
Doing
some quick work there with his backward skating and stick handling. Keeping it in the zone, number 13, big hit after the fact.
Rolled straight into his own player.
Just over 4 minutes left.
Oh, New Zealand come away with it. New Zealand are just...
Another sniper shot.
Wow.
Where is this guy sitting?
That offload to nobody. And it's New Zealand to come away with it, looking for a way through.
But and, Koo with an opportunity. He's
shot
gone
to
through.
Come.
Oh, what a beaut!
Goal! What a goal! That was top quality.
Koo managing to get that top shelf after going through two guys. What a beautiful shot. Look at that stick handling. What an action shot. Up to top shelf. Beautiful chip in there. What a
Gerard,
snap.
No opportunity to stop that one. It
awesome.
Was past him by the time he reached his hand out.
What an answer from Hong Kong. 2-all, 4 minutes and 14 seconds left in the period. This is a dead even game. These two teams are fighting the fight, and I'm thinking we might just have an overtime. But we still got a whole third period.
Exactly.
It'll be nice to see an overtime, but, you know, they obviously want to have an outright win. Hong Kong putting the pressure on again.
Let's see what the response is from New Zealand. You could see that Hong Kong was stung by that second goal from New Zealand. They fought back, and quick response from them.
Sure. Koo got that unassisted. Beautiful. Sorry, Rex Koo. Let me say the full name. Rex Koo, number 3, got the unassisted goal.
Still, it's New Zealand. Still, going right across the face of the Hong Kong goal. Nobody there, though, to take advantage of it. Kerry making a nuisance of himself, but it's still Hong Kong.
They fixed the goal for New Zealand. They've given it to Sebastian Chamberlain without an assist. So after watching the replay, they've definitely checked it up in the points box. So it didn't get a tip-off anybody, as we thought. Initially, it kind of looked like it, but it was definitely even the wrong player. So I think a good call there by the results managers from IIHF.
3 minutes almost exactly on the clock to play in the second period. It's tied at 2 apiece as New Zealand come away with it, looking for a way through.
What
wow!
Way.
And a shot comes in, not to take advantage of it. Nobody there, though. The rebound.
Oh, just getting caught too low down was the...
Yes, danger. Great defense there. Well done. And
Barry
once again,
the
goal scorer, Chamberlain, turns defense.
It's great back checking, Jeremy. That's the word.
That's what I wanted to say. Exactly what I wanted to say. Here we go.
Lamb with it now. Lamb passing.
Kerry looking for even a sniff.
2 minutes, 20 seconds. Hong Kong with it. 8. Big shot. Denied.
These New Zealand boys are big. You're going to struggle to get past them easily.
But 8. Lamb. 8 from Hong Kong. He's a big boy. And offside.
And shot comes in.
And goal! Hong Kong putting one up on the board. One up against 2 minutes left exactly.
It's almost like he curved it around the player in front of him.
Ooh, what, Matrix style? Curving
Gerard was almost unsighted. He almost didn't see it. Let's have a look again. You see the replay. You see the
number
traffic
19.
In front of him. And he goes around 6 Berry.
Beautiful. Wow.
And it's almost as if Gerard was expecting it to go the other way.
Darren Chang, number 19 for Hong Kong.
Well, I'll tell you what.
Bend it like Beckham.
Well, yeah,
now
exactly.
Bend it like Chang.
I'll tell you what, amazing shot there, absolutely, from a Hong Kong.
Chung.
Let's have a look
3
now.
3-2. New Zealand now coming back.
This is going to take
a
little
bit. Are they going to answer?
Bit of a deep breath required from New Zealand.
Some big hits coming now.
Still Hong Kong come at them.
Quick fast feet, quick hands. Setting it up, big shot high. Up
over
to defense.
The top, no worries.
New Zealand have an opportunity here. Lewis with it, looking for the pass to 21. Big pass, and it went through, but into the goalie.
Wow.
Saved beautifully there by the number one keeper.
Let's have a look at this one again.
Good opportunity for New Zealand. They are now wanting to answer this third goal.
Bodies on the line, just not able to control it. And in fact, talk about bodies on the line, they threw themselves in front of the puck.
Yeah. great defensive, great back checking there by the Hong Kong team. New Zealand want this. They got a face off now. They have an opportunity. 1.5 minutes left.
Danger, danger, danger. Though, of course, deep inside the Hong Kong half of the ice. Shot to come. Skids into the back, looking for a way. There's about 60 odd seconds, 70 seconds to go in this second period.
Sticks flying.
Now what?
Delamatao dumping it down. Big hit there after the puck had left. Nine, keeping a shot down on the ice. Number 15 tried to wrap around there.
Yeah. Could see the intent, just not able to execute. In comes the long range effort. And again, looking for it. Scramble across the face of goal. 38 seconds to go. Good setup.
Go.
And shot comes in.
Up into the out of bounds area. Beautiful shot there by Hayward Jones from the point, but I think it got either deflected or he shot too high. 31 seconds left in the second period. Our shot count showing 21-18. It's very equal, and yet Hong Kong are in the lead with less shots at this point.
Yep.
Hong Kong kind of winning that, but New Zealand getting their stick on it. Hong Kong still trying to get away with it. 20 seconds. Oh.
Wow, how did that stay out?
Great
effort there.
New Zealand are putting it in there, trying hard to get it through. Not quite getting on there.
This is such a great display. It's nice to see, because what it tells you, even though they don't score now, is that New Zealand are intent on getting into the game. Here comes the shot.
Oh!
Just a miscue.
Just missed it. Oh, what an effort. What an effort. Shame. That was brilliant work
from
by the
New Zealand 11,
team.
Marcus McDonald, of course.
Great
hockey.
Wow. Exciting stuff, people.
Yeah.
Very exciting.
Okay, look, the facts of the matter is that it's 2-1 in the second period, 3-2 in the match, of course, with one period of play still to come. Obviously, it'll
look
be hot.
Just couldn't get the
just
control.
He missed
the
completely fresh air.
Puck was just bobbling around, and it just got past the front of his stick to get that shot.
You know, sometimes you need a little bit of luck. It's not always the skill that will win you the game. Sometimes it's the luck that will win you the game as well.
Yeah.
And just for that split second, it was Hong Kong that had a little bit of luck. Of course, there's one entire period of play still to come. 3-2 the score in favor of Hong Kong, with a shot counter, which suggests it should be the other way around. 24-18, or what is it?
Refresh it, yeah.
24-18, the shot counter is in New Zealand's favor, but I don't think that's going to worry them. They know that they've still got another period of play to come. They know that they are able to get past the Hong Kong defense. You know, it feels to me like Hong Kong are able to turn it on when they need to. And it's almost as if they sort of go to sleep. And I mean, I don't mean that in a nasty way at all. It's almost as if they sort of go, we sort of kind of conserve ourselves for a while. And then it's all New Zealand. It's one-way traffic. It is monster. And then when they need to, it's almost like Hong Kong go, okay, let's put our foot on the accelerator again.
Yeah.
And that's what seems to happen. Really looking forward. Yeah, they change the pace. They're able to change direction. As you can see, they can change the outcome of that scoreboard. 2-1 at one stage to New Zealand, looking really good. Looked like they were going to take over. Not to be, as we end that second period of play. 3-2 ahead for Hong Kong. Looking forward to an action-packed third and final period of play.
Definitely am. And, I mean, wow, I'm just enjoying the hockey so much. These under-18s have impressed people all over the world watching this. You know, this is the lowest level in, the juniors. For world championships, and these teams are really shining. For juniors, they're doing very well. I mean, with Thailand being their debut, they did such a good job. So I'm looking forward to the rest of the tournament. Tonight's game with South Africa versus Thailand is going to be very, very exciting as well. I mean, they're matching up against the top tier team in this division versus the brand new guys, and I think that Thailand are really going to give South Africa a good run for their money. But anyway, having said that, let me give a shout out to our sponsors again. Once again, they are the ones that make this possible in our beautiful city of Cape Town. And so here we go. City of Cape Town, Aquila, Ice Station, Western Cape Government, DigiCape, Lowburg Meat, Department of Sports, Arts and Culture, Signage Hub, CompuTicket, Eurosteel, Carol Boys, Heart FM, SASCOM, Western Province Ice Hockey Association, intro, South African Ice Hockey Federation, Graphic Thought Design, Double IHF, The Sun, Grand West, Pedigree Media, the guys who are putting on this live stream. Thank you to all of you guys, and CFW fans, to keep the kit clean and dry. Cheers, guys. See you in a few minutes.
Right, folks, about 60 seconds before we get the third and final period underway of what has been a really exciting, very entertaining game of ice hockey. It's the second day of the 2023 IIHF Ice Hockey Under 18 World Championships Division 3B being played out at the Grand West Ice Rink in Cape Town, South Africa. The match, of course, New Zealand up against Hong Kong. It's been a ding-dong battle with one team taking the lead. Then the other one will fight back and they will go into the lead. But eventually, at the moment, as we head into the start of the third period, it's Hong Kong with a 3-2 advantage. And I tell you, it'll take a brave person to come away with what? To make a prediction here. What are your thoughts as we head into the final period, Nadine Sheffield?
I was actually just chatting to my friend Jonathan Berger, who's our results manager here in Western Province. And we were both like, we're calling it. Is it going to be an overtime game? We both think it's going to be an overtime game. We're hoping it is. But again, it's not really necessarily a nice turnout for the teams on the ice, but it's a good thing for South Africa if that happens. But it's also exciting for the fans. But here we go. Face-off won by the New Zealand team. Is there going to be a quick goal?
Oh, the last time you said that, somebody scored in 15 seconds.
Exactly. Commentator's curse? Or commentator's... I don't know. What's the positive of a curse?
Oh, let's see. Blessing. Here come New Zealand.
Oh, just missing that stick right in the corner there. He could have got it in.
Sure, they missed that one. Wow.
So close, but so far. Hong Kong turning it over. Here we have Yam with it up the boards. And he takes it right around number 9 and passes it through. And it got a goal! Hong Kong with... just on, what, 37 seconds.
You asked for an early goal. I think there we go.
So it's not a commentator's curse. It's a commentator's blessing.
Blessing, yeah, could be.
Maybe. I've got the power.
You certainly seem to have the power.
They have the power. Well done, Hong Kong. What a great effort. What a great goal. That's putting a security goal on the boards. 4-2 in the final period of this game. Hong Kong are showing that they are here to stay. New Zealand are now going to be very rattled, and they better come back strong if they want to keep in this game. And I'm pretty sure they can do it.
I mean, if you think about it, the game the period started. Great effort.
Is it in? Is it over? The goalie's inside the crease. He's creeping forward. No, it's definitely out. It's definitely not over the line. Whew.
Look at the start of this period of play, this final period of play. Almost a goal for New Zealand. Immediately gets turned around. Runs up the ice by who? The danger man, number 7 for Hong Kong, Yang Yam, who was able to, not necessarily score it, but certainly caused so much pandemonium.
I'm sorry, but my stats page, you usually get an arrow 404.
Yeah.
I have an arrow 503 saying slow down.
Yeah, slow down.
No jokes. I have no idea when. I've never seen that before on an internet code.
It's a new internet code.
Anyway, that was scored there by Randolph Muck, number 23, and assisted by Yu Yam, number 7. Here we go. New Zealand with an opportunity.
Lewis didn't see Simpson just lurking with intent on the right-hand side. In comes the shot. Now Simpson comes away with it. The no-look back pass goes straight to a Hong Kong player.
Lots of changes happening now for the New Zealand.
All change for New Zealand. Fresh legs on.
The forwards. No, defense. We have number 3. Also, definitely showing his skills tonight, or today, from the Hong Kong team. And that's Rex Koo. Been very vital in today's game. Hong Kong just not managing to keep control of it down in the neutral zone, managing to go down into the defensive zone now. Koo with it now, looking to look up to Lee. Lee's got it, can get through. Good stick work there, good pass to 22, up to the point, number 10. Back down, but not going to number 22. We've got Koo with it in the corner. New Zealand managing to come away with it. Patterson Drop pass. Beautiful.
Great shot again.
And another rebound. New Zealand putting that pressure on. Keeping it down low.
This is what Hong Kong do, as I was saying to you at the end of that second period of play. They do the damage, and then they'll sort of go into autopilot mode, and then they'll sort of wake up again and do something else. They've got a two-goal advantage now.
Leung with it.
16 minutes to go. Great shot. Effort there.
Great save there by the number 20 goalkeeper for New Zealand. Sure. 25 shots to 20. New Zealand leading with shot scoring. Shot taking, should I say. Yeah, I'm facing up, winning it back. Can you keep your fists down, Wimmer?
Just now to see the composure of both teams, in fact. Dealt with by David Lam for Hong Kong, casually sort of posing against the goalpost.
So Patrick is asking if Hong Kong win this game, are they promoted? No, Patrick, not yet, because there's still another two games to be played on Thursday, and it's still part of the round robin. And South Africa have got to play Thailand today, and then on Thursday, the lineup, I think, is New Zealand, South Africa, and Thailand, Hong Kong. So it all depends on those games. Slight trip there, but yes. I don't know if it was the sniper or if it was the player this time.
Definitely the player.
New Zealand putting the pressure on.
Looking for the
up in the air and loose. Oh, and just not getting quite enough control on it to get a shot accurate.
Looking for the layoff.
New Zealand are looking very composed at the back. Hong Kong taking it very slow, subtle, not attacking aggressively, but still coming away with it. They're patient. McDonald with it now. McDonald got a chance. Not quite getting through onto the net.
Too much traffic in front of him. And no way through. Here comes New Zealand looking for a way through. Shot comes in. Massive deflection. And again, Hong Kong doing what they need to do to keep the New Zealanders out. But here come New Zealand. It's just a sea of black jerseys.
Koptev just dumping it down into the corner, but Hong Kong are managing to keep it, but Koptev keeping it down in the corner again.
Koptev happy to wear the ball on the face, but doing what he needs to do for the team.
Four to two, just on 14 and a half minutes left. Here we go.
The last thing that New Zealand wants is to leak another goal now, because then it is over.
Yeah.
I can still see a scenario that says New Zealand come back from two goals down. Three, not so much.
No icing called there. Hong Kong doing a great job of getting ahead. New Zealand picking it up. Can they get a turnover? Are they going to go back and get an answer to this goal? No. Hong Kong back in control.
Great skating skills, I'm loving it. And the stick works so good.
New Zealand, there's four of them down there, making sure that puck comes out of their zone. Hong Kong gonna get some changes. Setting it up nicely. New Zealand's putting some average pressure on, nothing too hectic. You know what, there's been hardly any penalties of late.
Noticed that as well. We haven't had that many power plays. Great effort there from the danger man. Yao looking for a way through.
There's actually only been two penalties in this whole tournament, in this whole game. Well kept in there by number 7, Yam, firing it off, trying to get the deflection there with Leung Chung.
Shot to come. Able to keep it out there.
Number 14, Carey with it. Up. Back to Carey.
In
big
comes
shot.
The shot. kept out.
Yeah,
Hong Kong
with it.
Able to close the door.
Big shot and well saved.
Yeah, Gerard up to that one. Yam Lithery comes on for like 30, 40, 50 seconds and then he's gone.
Yeah.
But in that 30, 40, 50 seconds, he makes such a difference.
This game can still go either way. I know Hong Kong's in the lead, but they're definitely showing more composure right now than New Zealand at the moment. Their possession and their puck control is definitely much more superior at the moment than New Zealand. Let's see if New Zealand can pull it back.
I feel as if New Zealand feel the gap, the two-goal gap, as if it's a really serious mountain to climb up. I mean, I'm just feeling the weight in terms of their efforts. It does feel a little bit frantic. They realize they've got to score, and they've got to score quickly.
And they are going to keep trying. Ooh!
He
looks sore. He did do a bit of a flippy flip. He looks very painful. The referee should be stopping. Tell the guy to get up. If he's injured, I know, but he's sore. He's really hurting. His back is super sore. He shouldn't have had to skate. That was number 13, Fong.
Wow,
who
that
got
looks,
hurt.
Yeah, very serious, I've got to tell you.
We're going to see the replay. I don't know.
Not too sure if he fell onto the poles.
I don't think he did. I just think that he got hit pretty hard and did a hectic twist.
Here it is. You'll see.
His leg. No, he landed straight on his back after that leg went flying up and over. Definitely a hell of a hit. Misconduct for New Hong Kong. Who? Is he calling for Hong Kong or New Zealand? And if he's calling it, why?
Well, as soon as we work out what on earth he was saying, in the meantime, it's all New Zealand. Got a feel though for that that Hong Kong player. Did seem like a really painful blow that he took to the back as he virtually crawled off the ice. Play underway now, of course, as Hong Kong look for that deciding goal. A 5-2 advantage will be...
I just saw a whole lot of ice flying up somewhere.
Yes, exactly. I saw
that
the same
weird.
Thing. 5-2 advantage would be, I think, the end of this story. But if there's an opportunity for New Zealand to pull one back, then we might very well have an enticing last sort of 10 minutes or so in this encounter.
I'm very interested to know what that call was that ref called. Because he definitely showed a misconduct, but no one got off the ice. 11 minutes left in this game.
Yep.
4-2. Shots. 24-19, I think. Well, let me see. No, wait. I got that wrong. 26-23.
Great effort. Saved there by David Lamb. The danger man Yam is on the ice, and as I said before, he comes on literally 30, 40, 50 seconds and causes so many problems, and then he's gone.
Yeah, and he's facing up against Carey. I mean, Carey's also like the scary one for the New Zealand team. He's got some serious skills on him. And look at these two legends facing up against each other now. No, the referee's still going back. Let's see what's going to happen here. They should have done this a while ago. Oh, he's you know what? He's kicking a team official off and out. He's kicking a team official off the bench, whether it was a coach or not, but he's not supposed to be there. Okay. That looks like what his call was.
Obviously, the team official had a few words to say after that
incident.
Felt like there should have been some action taken. Mm. Wasn't. And may have... in the heat of the moment, said a few things.
Offside. So yes, it's a team penalty. Second misconduct penalty. 20 minutes for that team official.
So, 20 minutes.
No, basically he just gets kicked off the bench. He's not allowed to come back on the bench.
But it has no bearing on the team as a whole. There's nothing for them to have to worry about.
No, at this point.
There you go. New Zealand still looking for a way through. I tell you what. Hong Kong doing just enough.
Perry and Yam again in the corner.
That, for the time being, is all that they need to do. Just not able to control it. New Zealand looking for a little bit of composure. And great effort there. Here we go. Danger,
Yam.
danger. As Yam comes up the ice, stolen away from him on this particular occasion. And he's gone.
Well, he picked it out of the air.
Yeah.
And now he's gone to rest his legs. If Hong Kong can hold a defensive game now and just play solid D, they've got it.
Yeah. In fact, Yam can go to the change rooms and change now. Because they don't need him.
They do. The more score that they can get, the safer it is. Opportunity here, looking for the wraparound. Good defensive work by Hong Kong.
Keep one in the corner and around the corner shot.
Well, it is kind of, but we call them wraparounds.
Wraparounds.
Opportunity here for Hong Kong again. Number 21.
Licking it behind behind the New Zealand goal. Shot comes in behind. Good, well kept out there by Gerard. Still not done. Still the pressure comes from Hong Kong. They're looking to close this one out. Promise you a fifth goal and it is all over.
Number 22 is racing it up the side. Oh, he just fell. But a referee is going to call a tripping on number 4. Oh, he's calling it a hook. Let's watch a replay, but I'm pretty sure it was the sniper this time. But let's see if the hook is the correct call. Number 4 hooking for Hong Kong. And that is Curtis Chan.
He's called it hooking. Let's have a look. I mean...
Yeah.
Yep.
Well, it's more of a slash, but I don't know if that fall was necessarily caused by the slash. But anyway, he saw what he saw. So good for the referee. It was still a foul. It was more of a slash on the hands.
Chan's going to spend 20 minutes. I beg your pardon. Two minutes. 20 minutes is a really long
time. 2 minutes in the sin bin. Regardless, he's getting it.
I think with 8.5 minutes left to go, Nadine Sheffield, I think Hong Kong have done enough.
They have, but now they've got a penalty kill. So they have to be very careful because New Zealand are extremely strong on their power play.
Let's
see if they can get one in. Maybe two, but let's see.
New Zealand now needing to be very accurate and composed, which of course are two hallmarks of their play anyway.
Carey just gliding it through, looking for the pass, getting it in, but not quite getting it onto stick. Hong Kong clearing it out. New Zealand setting it up.
Chamberlain comes away with it.
Beautiful pass to Carey.
Great.
Carey chips it over, but into our Leong.
In comes the shot, well dealt with there. Lamb, very comfortable as he took that one.
These goalies have been working hard tonight, today. I keep saying tonight, it's not a night yet. It's still during the day. Great job by both goalies, actually. Just under 8 minutes, guys. And then 1.5 minutes left in the penalty kill for the Hong Kong team. Can they defend it? Carey, quick pass to number 9 on the side. Heywood Jones.
Kerry calling for it. Get out the way, ref, is what they're saying.
Good job there by the Hong Kong team to clear it. They're getting some well deserved changes.
The referee from Kuwait taking that one in the chest or maybe a little bit lower. But still,
Hong Kong. Great pressure here by the number 21, Wong.
Looking for a way through. Still, of course, we've got the power play.
Oh, what a great work. He got through and they have a shot. Whoa, did you see that dude's glove? But it did, I don't think it hit the puck, but the puck went out of bounds. But jeez. Beautiful glove work there. Great save.
Let's have a look at this.
New Zealand tried really hard. Great pass through the slot. Really, really. I don't even know where it went.
Deflected off something.
Yeah. Another big shot saved.
You heard it thud against the the goalies, what do they call those things? Pads in the front.
Yeah. Offside. Very offside.
All the pressure, all of the intensity coming from New Zealand at the moment, quite obviously, as they are chasing a two-goal deficit. Hong Kong can afford to just soak up the pressure. They can afford to sit back and watch. But I tell you what, it's when they decide to revive their attacking abilities that is just scary. New Zealand still with it. Still 30 seconds left on the power play. They've had a couple of opportunities. They've not been able to make it count. They're going to want to. They need to as we get under 7 minutes left in the final period of play. Coming, dancing his way through.
Stick is flying again. I've seen a lot of lost sticks in this tournament. Oh, just not quite in the right spot.
Nobody. Chamberlain comes
big
in with a bullet.
Shot.
And so unlucky there.
Where is the puck? Oh, it's loose. Great clearance there by Hong Kong. Driving himself into the referee. Oh, somebody lost something there. Hong Kong with a chance. Here goes Koo. Koo looking for a shot. Wide of the net. 6 minutes left. Lee. Lee looking for the pass. Up. Bit of a dangerous pass. There's going to be an ice call. Just on 6 minutes left. Score 4-2 still. New Zealand not managing to come back. 31 shots to 23 at the moment. Hong Kong.
Looking hard.
Great
about
work
that
by Lee. No foul there. Lee back with the puck.
Stick work and skating is just so good.
New Zealand have the puck now, but back into possession of Hong Kong. A lot of work here in the neutral zone. No one quite getting control of it long enough to make a play. Here we go. 19. Taken away. Stolen by the New Zealand players. Opportunity.
Shot comes in. It's the Danger Man Yam. Not able to make it count.
Danger Man Yam. Oh, great name.
One Danger Man to the next.
Now they've definitely put these lines on against each other. They're well matched, these two lines. Allen to Lewis. Mark picking it up. Chong. Hong Kong getting some changes in. New Zealand carry with it.
He's leading from the front as he always has done.
Head on a swivel looking for
and
his partner.
Shot to come. Sebastian Chamberlain just not able to get hold of it.
Allen on the side. Through the middle to carry. Carey looking for a quick shot, denied by Mark, getting his legs closed, quickly stopping that puck. Great defensive work.
Hong Kong doing what they need to do. It doesn't have to be pretty.
Exactly.
All that matters is at the end of the next 4 minutes and 5 seconds, it still needs to read 4-2, and they will be happy with their efforts today.
I think. 3 minutes 56 seconds. New Zealand, can they do it? There's high hopes in the stands. There's a lot of New Zealand fans wanting these guys to come back and get some goals. It is possible. 4 minutes is nothing to get 2 goals. But you've got to work really hard, and you have to have an opponent that's not going to let you, well, that is going to let you do it. And I don't think Hong Kong are that opponent.
No. Hong Kong know exactly how their game works. They've got a game plan. It's certainly working for them. As I said, you know, it seems to me as if they switch on and switch off through the course of the game. And right now, the need to just hold them at bay is all that is required.
Good setup there by New Zealand, but also, again, just not getting through the traffic in the slot. Kwok with it now. Big shot, but deflected. gain possession-wise. Hong Kong have had a lot of possession. They have more puck time than New Zealand did. You know, and it just shows. It shows on the scoreboard.
Yep, exactly.
Although New Zealand's have a lot more shots.
Right.
Here we have Linton. Linton,
shot
beautiful
in,
shot,
dealt
but
with
wide.
There by Lamb.
Lamb definitely making sure it's not going in his top corner.
Looking for his teammate who wasn't there as Hong Kong come away with it.
Koo to Lee. Lee, quick to Koo, and a big shot, but saved by the netminder. Definitely doing his job, not letting them get through.
Two and a half minutes left in this match, in this final period of play. I think that
Hong Kong Koo with it.
Danger, danger, danger. Sydney, a really good player.
Ooh, cool. And there's going to be a penalty call there. Is he going to get a penalty shot or not? Holding. Number 11 from New Zealand's getting a holding call. And his name is Marcus McDonald. Do we have a replay? Here we go.
Here it comes. You can see him come across him.
Yes, definitely a hole. But it was more like the Hong Kong guy pulled him down.
Did look like some sort of locked arms. And
but
in
you
fact,
know,
he got up straight away as if to go, I didn't hold him.
In the rest defense, he didn't see a replay like we just did. So it could have been called that way.
Having a conversation now with the officials, the coaching team out at the New Zealand bench.
They had their conversation. Let's play. 2 minutes left, and New Zealand are on a penalty kill. They'll have 14 seconds with equal strength. Patterson on the penalty kill, and they're attacking, and they get a goal!
And Carey. It's that man, Jacob Carey.
What a
it's that man,
shorthanded
Jacob Carey.
Goal. Beautiful work there. It just basically riled them up. So now we've got 3-4, 2 minutes left. I told you, it is very possible.
Very possible. Lots of work still to be done.
Great work there by the New Zealand. What a comeback.
It's
Carey
almost like they needed to
Patterson.
Be one less because it just all of a sudden opened up their own space for themselves. Great effort there from Carey.
Timeout for the teams. Shoo. We needed that excitement.
Have a look at this one. Sneaks it almost at right angles. There we go, against the pole, and
oh, it just trickles in at the last second.
I mean,
it has to go across the line fully.
It's got to break the line completely,
yes. And it was on the line, and then over the line. Love the camera angle. Okay, and they gave that to Joel Patterson, number 16, and assisted by Jacob Carey. I think it's supposed to be the other way around.
Definitely the other way around, folks. I can tell you that it was not John Patterson who scored that one.
No, it was Carey that scored and Patterson got the assist. Right. Face off. 2 minutes, 5 seconds, 43. New Zealand winning it, getting a quick shot down. Remember, they are on a penalty kill. Just had
go.
A shorthanded goal. It's definitely boosted their morale for this last few minutes. But Hong Kong are going to say, we are still here. Where did it go?
Wow, it's like he took that in the face and then it bounced off somewhere.
It's next game today is at 7 p.m. South African time.
Fizzing away. It's still Hong Kong. They've got a chance. In it comes. Queuing up just to get the bodies in the way, make it difficult.
Ooh, come on, where's that? After the whistle. That's a misconduct. pushed him way after the whistle from behind, I would have definitely given him something. Come down there, come on, ref. Not allowed to be nasty to the ref. New Zealand, can they come back with another one? I'm hoping yes. For my own personal reasons, I'm hoping yes. 1 minute 30 left. 1 minute 16 in the penalty kill. There are now six players of Hong Kong on the ice, plus the goalie. Okay, we've got Yam, who's now in the defensive position. Koo up front. These two are the guys to be watching. Number three, Koo manages to keep it through, get it in. New Zealand doing a great job of clearing it.
80 seconds left on the game. It's 4-3 in favor of Hong Kong.
Glad to see they fixed it on the results here. They've definitely fixed the assist and the goal. Right. New Zealand. Lewis. Quick up to carry.
Accuracy.
Offside.
I was about to say accuracy and composure required. But certainly no offside call. That was the other thing I should have said, maybe.
Just on 1 minute left, guys. 4-3. This has been a really exciting game. Very, very even. On the teams, they are just working so hard, both of them. New Zealand just not quite getting enough shots in the net. They're getting enough on target, but not in the net. Let's hope they can get another one in.
That was an interesting option that they took to smash it down and give away the icing. Does of course bring New Zealand very much into the danger zone for the next 40 seconds. I beg your pardon, 56 seconds. I'm shortchanging them.
They've taken their goalie out, just by the way. They've got five players on for the last minute. They are trying to get a goal on the board. And here they have a chance.
It's in!
They say it's in. And the referees called it a goal. They've done it. The tactic worked. The goalie got off.
Got to see that
five
again.
Five men on, and they managed to sneak it in past that goalie.
He thought he had it. David Lamb was in position.
That was good.
He was in position. Let's have a look here. You'll see the reverse angle on it. Gets behind it and steals it back, does Kerry.
Stick work on that man.
And shot comes in. Bang. And just
trickles in Wounded Rabbit under the goalie's legs.
Wounded Rabbits, I love them.
Well done. Okay, we'll call this one a Wounded Kiwi.
Wounded Kiwi, Flying Kiwi, whatever it takes.
Sliding Kiwi.
And I got to say, Lady Sheffield, you called this. You called a 4-4 end of regulation play result.
Tinsel fan, commentator's curse. Really? Yeah.
She is terrible, I've got to tell you.
There we go.
Kerry's not done. He's keen maybe to slot a fifth. Inside regulation. Offloads it now.
Never mind. So Jacob Carey got that goal unassisted. Definitely unassisted. He stole that puck right away from the Hong Kong player.
Hong Kong not done. Imagine a last gasp shot to come.
And you know, New Zealand are still short-handed. There's just on 15 seconds left. If they don't shut this down.
Yam with the puck, looking for a way through. Not to be. Shot to come in.
5-on-5. And it's a goal!
It's a goal!
5-on-5. As you stepped on the ice, they scored 8.8 seconds on the clock. Score 4-4. How's that for it? Now it's 5-all. I mean 5-4. Ooh, Hong Kong. Hong Kong have just proved that they can come and answer. New Zealand have put in such hard work, such effort.
That is heartbreak for New Zealand and just ecstasy for Hong Kong.
They are going to probably call Paul the goalie again. Maybe, maybe not. Not in this position. I wouldn't. Not in this defensive zone or the neutral zone. Yep, they're calling him. They're pulling him. They want six man on. They really want to get 8 seconds. They've got to get a good clean shot. Carries here. Oh man. They're delaying the game. Okay. 8 seconds. A lot of people were hoping for the overtime, but Hong Kong definitely deserve this win if they get it. Wow. They worked really hard for it.
What a game we've seen.
Big
here.
Shot. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh, they've done it. Hong Kong have done it, and it's a no goal. Okay. Woo, Hong Kong are super excited. Look at that. Oh, they just killed their goalie. They killed their goalie. Well done, Hong Kong.
Well, I've got to tell you, outstanding effort from Hong Kong. You can see what it means to Yam celebrating. I know that we've still got a couple of games left to play, but that might very well be, at the end of the day, the gold medal match that we've just seen. 5-4, the final result. New Zealand must go away from this, and they must really hold their heads up high. They fought back shorthanded, scored shorthanded in those last few minutes. Hong Kong refused to go away, refused to give up, and they snuck one at the end. I've got to tell you, literally a split second after the buzzer sounded, it was in the back of the Hong Kong net. It took a very sort of animated gesture from the referee, Abdullah Al-Zidan, to go, no, that was definitely not a goal inside regulation time. A win for Hong Kong. Really good performance from both teams. What a spectacle. What an exhibition of ice hockey. And as I say, I think we might very well go, that is the gold medal decided, albeit with three games still to play.
What an amazing outcome for Hong Kong. Very impressive. Definitely, you know, they were ranked lower than New Zealand in this, but they've definitely wanted it more. And we've seen it period to period. They just came back fighting. And they've got some beautiful snipers in that team. Great effort by New Zealand, though. I must say, I take my hats off to them. They really did a great job of coming back. But, you know, Hong Kong, unfortunately, just really wanted it that much more. So great job there for both teams. Hold your heads high. Let's see who the MVPs are. Oh, by the way, the last goal was scored by Darren Cheong, number 19, and assisted by Yam Yong. I mean, Yao Yam. Sorry, getting it backwards.
Ladies and gentlemen, the goal stands in the end of a fantastic matchup. The final score stands.
I mean, just looking at the faces of the New Zealand players, you know, it's one of those that you don't have to like the result.
No.
It's okay to be disappointed.
It is.
But I can tell you that they did so well. Contested literally to the very, very last second. End of the day, though, we have to have a winner. And that, of course, today goes the way of Hong Kong. What a brilliant performance. We say that they sort of switch on and switch off. Well, they certainly felt like they switched off those two goals coming from New Zealand, but able to switch back on and get that deciding score.
Oh, they're super excited. Everybody in hockey knows when there's sticks and gloves and helmets lying all over the place, we know what that means. That means almost medal stuff. Jack Lewis getting it for the MVP, number 22 for the New Zealand team this afternoon, South Africa time. Well done, Lewis.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and the best player for the winning team in this matchup for Hong Kong goes to play number 19, Darren Cheong.
Darren Cheong getting the MVP for this game, number 19. He looks so young.
I was going to say.
They don't look so young when they're on the ice and they have their helmets on. Awesome work. Awesome work, well deserved. Guys, don't forget to join us later at 7 o'clock for the SA game versus Thailand.
We'll be right back.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, a very big thank you going out to everybody
who
joined us here this afternoon for this fantastic action-packed matchup. We hope to see you here later on this evening, where the puck will drop at 7 p.m. in the matchup between Thailand and South Africa.
All right, guys. Well, definitely an exciting game this afternoon, and I'm hoping that tonight's game is going to be a bit more exciting with South Africa playing.
More exciting? I don't think I can think more exciting than what I've just seen.
Of course you can.
Goodness me, I tell you what, this was an absolute spectacle. 5-4, 9 goals in this particular game. Of course, it's South Africa against Thailand a little bit later tonight, 7 p.m. local time is when that one gets underway. Lots for South Africa to play for. I'm going to describe it as a must-win scenario for them. They're certainly going to want to bounce back after last night, showing 4-2 they lost last night to the same Hong Kong team. And they showed glimpses of serious skill, serious composure, just not able to get it past this very polished Hong Kong outfit. Yeah. Let's see what happens tonight. It's going to be a really tight affair, make no mistake. Thailand are not coming here to skate around this ice. They're a good team and will certainly, you know, bring their very best sort of starting lineup to this occasion. It's underway at 7 o'clock tonight, and Sydney, looking forward to your company and joining us then.
No, definitely will. I'm looking forward to seeing everybody online. Please join us, send your shout-outs. We'll definitely try and get to them if you're not too involved in the exciting games. We do try. But if you're in South Africa, in Cape Town, come on down. Come and watch your local team playing. This is South Africa's home ground, and they need the support. You know, we always welcome everybody. Tickets are $100 to get in at the door. Please join us. Big shout out here to our sponsors, City of Cape Town, Aquila, The Ice Station, Western Cape Government, DigiCape, Bloberg Meat, Department of Sports, Art and Culture, Signage Hub, CompuTicket, Eurosteel, Carol Boys, Heart FM, SASCOC, Western Province Ice Hockey Association, Intro, South African Ice Hockey Federation, Graphic Thought Design Company, IIHF, Sun Grand West, Pedigree Media, and CFW Fans. From us for now, we'll see you at 7 o'clock. Cheers for now. We'll be right back.